that the motion passed.
Second member's motion. Honourable Andrew Leung will move a motion under Rule 49E, Bracket 2 of the Rules of Procedure to take note of the Personal Data Privacy Amendment Ordinance 2012 Commencement Notice, which was included in Report Number 12/12-13 of the House Committee laid on the table of this Council. According to the relevant debating procedure, I will first call upon Honourable Andrew Leung to speak and move the motion, and then call upon the chairman of the subcommittee formed to scrutinise the relevant item of subsidiary legislation to speak, to be followed by other members. And then I will call upon public officer to speak. The debate will come to a close after public officer has spoken, and the motion will not be put to vote. Members who wish to speak on the motion will please press the request to speak button. And I'll call upon Honourable Andrew Leung to speak and move the motion. Mr. Andrew Leung, President, as the Chair of the House Committee, in accordance with Rule 49E, Bracket 2 of the Rules of Procedure, I would like to move the motion under my name as printed in the agenda, that is to allow members to conduct a debate in relation to the Personal Data Privacy Amendment Ordinance 2012 Commencement Notice as included in the Report Number 12/12-13 of House Committee on Consideration of Subsidiary Legislation and Other Instruments. I now propose searching to you, and that is that the motion moved by Andrew Leung be passed. Honourable Chen Ting Po, Mr. President, as the Chairman of the Subcommittee on Personal Data Privacy Amendment Ordinance 2012 Commencement Notice, I would like to report to you the scrutiny of the Subcommittee. The Commencement Notice was made in accordance with Personal Privacy Amendment Ordinance 2012, so as to appoint the 1st of April 2013 as the date of commencement for the provisions in relation to direct marketing and legal assistance. The subcommittee has this as the main concern, that is to tie in with the commencement of the relevant provisions on the 1st of April. We'd like to know whether the PCPD is ready in relation to the provisions, as well as whether the direct marketing organizations are also ready. Say, for example, the forms needed as well as the written confirmations needed. And the PCPD has also reported to us about the promotional and public education work, as well as the work and the manpower arrangements for the legal assistance scheme. To draw up the consent or indication of no objection forms, as well as the written confirmations for the oral consent, the PCPD has said that standard forms have been given as examples so that the data users can present the content in an easily readable and understandable format for the written confirmation, so as to tie in with the requirements of the new regulatory regime. We do not object to the relevant provisions. We are not going to move any amendments. Thank you.
Does any other member wish to speak? If not, members have already spoken, and I'll call upon the Secretary for Constitution and Mainland Affairs to speak. The debate will come to a close after the Secretary has spoken. Secretary for Constitution and Mainland Affairs. Thank you, Mr. President. Let me give an overall reply. The Personal Data Privacy Amendment Ordinance 2012 Commencement Notice was made by the Secretary for Constitution and Mainland Affairs in accordance with Section 1.3 of the relevant ordinance to appoint 1st of April 2013 as the day on which Sections 20, 21, 38, Subsection 2, 39 and 43 of the Amendment Notice come into operation in relation to the provisions relating to the use of personal data in direct marketing and provision of such data for use in direct marketing. And the notice was gazetted on the 25th of January 2013 and tabled in Council on 30th of January 2013. At the meeting of the House Committee on the 8th of February 2013, members decided to form a subcommittee to scrutinise the notice. On the 22nd of February 2013, the subcommittee held a meeting with representatives of my bureau and office and the Office of the Privacy Commissioner for Personal Data, PCPD, to deliberate in detail the relevant provisions. I'd like to thank the work of the subcommittee and its members. The subcommittee has expressed concern about the readiness of the and the preparatory work of the relevant provisions before it comes into operation. Over the past few months, in relation to data subjects and the use of personal data by data users, in relation to the new regulatory regime, we asked the sector whether the they are prepared for the new regulatory regime, and we've also organized relevant promotional and public educational work, including the preparation of the new guidance on direct marketing and on the rights to refuse consent to the use of personal data by data users. We prepared simpler we prepared information leaflets. We've also held seminars with the for the sectors, including direct marketing related industries and also the financial industry, so on and so forth. And we also organized a series of training programs and the including the Hong Kong Retail Management Association. And we also expand the scope of these programs to cover the new provisions, and also we put up advertisements in professional publications. We've also prepared APIs to inform data subjects of their rights under the new provisions, and the APIs will shortly be broadcast on radio and TV upon commencement of the notice. And according to the ordinance, any the information leaflets on legal assistance for civil claims under the PDPO was prepared, and the information and copies are available online. Mr. President, we are ready for the commencement of the provisions in the notice, and upon its commencement, a new regulatory regime will be introduced to offer greater protection to data subjects. And aggrieved data subjects can also be provided with legal assistance so that they can seek compensation. Mr. President, I so submit. In accordance with Rule 49E, Bracket 9 of the Rules of Procedure, I shall not put any question on the motion. Third.